Hello and welcome to this spoken tutorial on built-in functions in awk. In this tutorial, we will learn about different types of built-in functions like arithmetic functions, string functions, input-output functions, and timestamp functions. We will do this through some examples. To record this tutorial, I am using Ubuntu Linux 16.04 operating system and Gedit text editor 3.20.1. You can use any text editor of your choice. To practice this tutorial, you should have gone through the earlier awk tutorials on this website. You should have some knowledge of any programming language like C or C++. If not, then please go through the corresponding tutorials on our website. The files used in this tutorial are available in the code files link on this tutorial page. Please download and extract them. Built-in functions are always available for awk to call. First, we will learn about the arithmetic functions. Square root function returns positive square root of a number x. Int function truncates x to an integer value. Exponential function gives the exponential of x. Log function returns natural logarithm value of x. Sine and cos gives sine x and cosine x respectively. Please note that argument x should be mentioned in radians. Let us look at an example to understand these functions. I have already written the code in a file arithmetic_function.awk. The same is available in the code files link. Here, we are printing the square root of a positive and negative number respectively. Next, we are printing the integer value for a positive and negative number respectively. Then, we are printing exponential of a small number and a very large number. After that, natural logarithm of positive and negative numbers are printed. We are also printing sine and cosine values of 0.52 radian, that is actually 30 degree. Let us execute the file in the terminal. Open the terminal by pressing Ctrl, Alt and T keys. Next, go to the folder where you have downloaded and extracted the files using cd command. Now type awk space -f space arithmetic_function.awk and press enter to see the output. Couple of things are clear from this output. Square root function gives square root of a positive number. It returns none or not a number if the number is negative. Int function gives the truncated integer of any positive or negative number. Exponential function gives exponential of a number. If the number is very large, the function will return INF. Natural logarithm of positive number is given by log function. If the number is negative, the function returns none. Sine and cosine functions return corresponding values. You can verify the values using your calculator. Now, let us look at random functions. Random functions returns any random number between 0 and 1, but never returns 0 or 1. Generated numbers will be random within one awk execution, but predictable across different executions of the awk program. SRAND function is used to provide seed value x for random function. In absence of x, date and time of day is used as the seed value. Let us understand these with an example. I have written a code for the random function and saved it as random.awk. Here, inside the for loop, Rand function will generate a random number between 0 and 1. Then the generated number will be multiplied by 50 and get printed. So this code will generate 5 random numbers within 50. Switch to the terminal and execute the file. Let me clear the terminal. Type awk space hyphen f space random.awk and press enter. See, it is giving 5 random numbers. What happens if I execute the code again? Press the up arrow key to get the previously executed command and press enter. We are getting the same output, which means awk is generating the same set of random numbers for every execution of the script. Then, how can we get a new set of random numbers in every execution? Switch to the code once again. Before the for loop, type srand function. Press Ctrl and S keys to save the file. Now switch to the terminal. Press the up arrow key to get the previously executed command and press enter. It is giving a different set of random numbers. So we can generate a new set of random numbers using srand function when it is used without an argument. Next, we will see some string functions. Length function gives the length of a particular string s. Index function determines the position of string s2 within the larger string s1. For example, index within parenthesis within double quotes Linux, comma within double quotes n returns 3. Let us see an example. Open the file awkdemo.txt. We know that each student in the awkdemo.txt file has a 4-digit roll number. Due to typing error, the roll numbers may have wrong number of digits. We can easily detect these using awk commands. Switch to the terminal. Let me clear the terminal. Now type the command as shown here. Here we are checking the length of the first field is equal to 4 or not. If not, then the particular record will get printed. Press enter. See, there is one roll number S02 that has been typed incorrectly. It has 3 digits, whereas all others have 4 digits. The substring function extracts a substring from a larger string S. Let me explain the parameter. Here S is the string. A denotes the position in S from which the extraction would start. B denotes the number of characters that would be extracted. Let us see one example. Switch to the awkdemo.txt file. Here, the first letter of the roll numbers represents the hostel code where the particular student resides. Say, we want to find the list of students who are staying in hostel A. To get that, let's switch to the terminal. Type the command as shown here. Here, we take the string denoted by $1. As we know, $1 represents the first field, that is, roll number in our case. Next, we extract a substring that starts at position 1 with the character length 1. Then, if it is equal to capital A, then that line from the file will get printed. Press enter to see the output. We got the list of students who are in hostel A. We have seen the function split earlier, so I am not explaining the details here. Please refer to the earlier awk tutorials if you have any doubt. There are some other functions which are related to input-output. System function helps us to run any Unix command within awk. Now we will run the Unix command date through awk command. In the terminal, type the command as shown here and press enter. Today's date and time is displayed on the terminal as an output. Now, why do we do this? We have kept only the begin section of the awk command. In real world scenarios, we may want to print the system date before displaying the required output. In that case, we would need to execute system commands from awk command. There are some functions dealing with timestamps like systime, strftime, etc. Browse through the internet to know about these functions. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learnt about different types of built-in functions like arithmetic functions, string functions, input-output functions, and timestamp functions. As an assignment, write an awk program to print the last field of every record, where name of the student as small u as the third letter, using the awkdemo.txt file. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The Spoken Tutorial Project team conducts workshops using spoken tutorials and gives certificates on passing online tests. For more details, please write to us. Please post your timed queries in this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by NMEICT, MHRD, Government of India. More information on this mission is available at this link. The script has been contributed by Antra, and this is Praveen from IIT Bombay signing off. Thank you for joining.